I would say there are two types of contraceptive methods. One is permanent method, one is temporary method. Both the methods can be used by any of the partners, male or female. In male, this contraceptive methods, the methods are not too many. For permanent method, there is only vasectomy, that's the only method that is there. In temporary methods, condom is the commonly used family planning method. In females, there are many different methods available. Again, in permanent method, ligation of fallopian tubes is the commonest method which is used. Though there are many other methods which have been tried, like plugging the ostia from inside, but the most commonly used method is tube ligation. And temporary methods are also many, like hormonal pills, then IUCDs like copper tea, then locally acting spermicidal jellies which are to be introduced into vagina, and then they act as spermicidal, so they kill the sperms when the sperms are deposited into vagina. Then there are diaphragms like barrier methods, diaphragms which are fitted into the vagina which prevents sperms from going in. These methods are there, but many times you find that in spite of using these methods, there are failures. Like while having intercourse, condom can slip or it can rupture. Then what has to be done? Or sometimes could be any other reason that the lady and the man doesn't use any family planning method. It could be unplanned sexual activity. And then what has to be done? That time, emergency contraceptive methods can be used. But again, one must remember that these are emergency contraceptive methods. They are not to be used as regular contraceptive methods. Nowadays, you find many times these young girls come that whenever they have intercourse, they take after morning pills, which is not correct. During that time, if you know that you are going to have intercourse, you should be prepared for it and use some contraceptive method so that you don't come under trouble. The common side effects are it's a hormone. So sometimes one feels nauseatic, there is breast tenderness, there is little giddiness, and but these side effects vanish within 24 hours. They are not long lasting. If you get very severe nausea, one can take something, some antiemetic or tablet to prevent nausea. Now some people advise taking these antiemetic tablets before taking these pills so that you don't get nausea. But it's not so severe or so common that one has to take every time this. Then other side effect is bleeding. Usually after taking these pills, that cycle becomes shorter. You get periods earlier, like withdrawal bleeding, that you take these tablets that within a few days you start getting bleeding. Now this also settles by itself. And it has seen that after say a month or so, you go back to your normal cycle pattern and later on nothing changes. So very important thing is these pills are emergency contraceptive pills. They should not be used as regular contraceptive pills because people do not understand it. And what they start doing is every time they have sex and they don't want pregnancy, they take these pills. But if you compare side effects of using contraceptives and side effects and risk involved in getting abortion done, there is no comparison. Is risk involved in getting abortion done is so high that it's always good to take preventive measures rather than going for abortion, which has some risk involved. And if you use some contraceptive method, then that's the best thing that one can do.